Well, I think if you're looking for diversity and inclusion and Latinx representation in movies, you look no further than Robert Rodriguez's filmography. He shows us what the world can be in his movies, and his movies are diverse without ever commenting on it, without ever underlining it and putting it in bold. It's just the kind of world you want to live in.
I grew up in San Antonio, Texas, where I was born in a family of 10 children. It's third oldest. My dad had a video camera and I borrowed it on the weekends and would make movies. And what was great about growing up in such a large family was that I had endless supply of cast and crew for my little home movies. And we'd shoot these little backyard adventures, really kind of precursors to Spy Kids.
I love the name of his studios, Troublemaker Studios. That's definitely who he was growing up in his family. And it's also who he is as a filmmaker.
When we went to make El Mariachi, we had these dreams of selling it to the Spanish home video market and doing just a feature-length version of all those short films we did summer after summer. And we made it in the same way that we made those home movies, which was no crew.
This was a kid who sold his body as a lab rat and sold all his blood to get the $8,000 he needed to make his movie.
Didn't expect it to go to festivals or be bought by a studio, much less win Sundance. That was all a big surprise and shock to me. I was only 23 years old.
You know, when I first met Robert, I went out to try out for the movie Desperado. And I remember walking into his office and he just kind of said, "You remind me of the bad guys in my high school." And I said, "I am the bad guys in your high school."
Robert first changed my life with his book, Rebel Without a Crew, which is the story of his making his first film, El Mariachi. That was such an example to me. It was so punk rock. You know, for me, as someone who wanted to break into the world of musical theater, which is really seems gated from the outside. It feels like a gated community and you don't have the pass. Here's a Robert Rodriguez saying, here are all the tools you need to make a movie. It's not that deep. You can do it yourself. And that's how I felt empowered to begin writing In the Heights, which was my first musical.
He saw something in me when we were doing Desperado. When we were doing Desperado, he started telling me about Machete. And then when we did Spy Kids, he automatically, "Well, your Uncle Machete." You know, Spy Kids just made me a household name, you know.
I remember seeing Spy Kids in college. I remember thinking, if this movie were out when I were a little kid, I'd be president of the United States by now. Because it was so empowering to watch these two Latino kids with their Latino parents and their Latino grandfather, Danny Trejo, save the world.
So when I did something like Spy Kids, even the studio was like, "Why are you making them Hispanic? Why don't you just make them American?" I said, "Well, they are American. It's based on my family." They weren't even being jerks. They were just asking, why take a chance? Why not just make them American, not Latin? And they were afraid that they would make this big movie and it would only appeal to a small audience. I said, "Okay, I've came up with a good argument." I said, "You don't have to be British to enjoy James Bond." And I realized that the problem was just systemic. There just weren't enough voices telling stories to make that commonplace. And casting Latinos only begins when you've written something that's for a Latino, or that you just happen to cast a Latino in a non-Latin role. I realized the person in power has to be making these decisions, which is why I started my own network.
El Rey Network was born out of advocacy. In 2011, 10 national Latino organizations joined forces to birth El Rey.
There's a level of urgency for our community to feel represented. When we are reflected in the mainstream media, when we are reflected in the mainstream stories and film and television, you get this level of not just acceptance, but inclusion.
It's a platform for creating shows that put Latino filmmakers through the pipeline and make them showrunners, make them editors, making them producers in a way that is empowering.
Because when you see the kinds of stories that Robert and all of the diverse filmmakers at El Rey project to the world, it makes it so much harder to demonize or to victimize or to demean Latinos in this country.
You know, in the times we're living now, I think we need like real live superheroes, not cape wearing suckers. You know, I always say there's two kinds of people in the world. There's those that want to make a difference and those that are taking up space. And I think Robert wants to make a difference in his community.
I had just done mariachi, and I went to go to a book signing that Ricardo Montalban was having, and he was in his wheelchair. This is before I got to work with him and become friends with him. I saw someone whisper in his ear who I was. I said, "That's the guy who did mariachi." And he stood up from his wheelchair, and he said, "You are the hope." And I was like, oh my God, that's like, I've got to live up to his expectation, because he can't do it anymore. But he sees that I'm the guy who's got to take what I'm doing in this very small way and run with it. As I became friends with him, I saw how he was a guy that thought beyond himself and thought about the community and was always doing things to elevate the community and the image of the Latino. And I realized that moment that he stood up from his wheelchair that I had to be that guy.
I think for me, the most impressive thing about Robert Rodriguez is his generosity. There's lots of versions of that story where you make your way up the hill and you go, oh my gosh, well, I'm a genius, here I am, this is how it happened. But Robert doesn't subscribe to that at all. Robert says, if I can make it up here, you can make it up here. You just gotta get started.
So many people are afraid of failing, but failing teaches you more than success. My greatest successes always came directly from my greatest failures, every time. So you just go by instinct, no matter what, move positively, inspire others, live a creative life, and you've got it all. Across the